Sometimes I wonder.
Several years ago, my daughter Catherine decided to move to Brooklyn, New York. So my son Dan and I hopped in the car and drove up to see her on a beautiful September day. The weather couldn't have been better. While we were there, I visited some movie locations, historic sites, and the real reason for going was to visit a few pizzerias. Brooklyn is famous for their pizza. In fact, this is where pizza started in America. So sit back and enjoy the video. All right, we're on the BQE. BQE, is that what it is? Brooklyn Queens Express. Brooklyn Queens Expressway.
Yeah.
And then right there in front of us is the Brooklyn Bridge. Some notoriety from the town of Trenton, New Jersey, where his company was. I've done some videos about it. And it's an impressive bridge. Actually, John A. Roebling died before it was started. Which, if you follow my video on that, you'll understand why. But we're almost to where our destination, and we should be there in about 10 minutes. Hey, here we are. We're in Mespath, M-E-S-P-A-T-H. And this is a scene from the Goodfellas movie. And right about over here someplace was a telephone booth that Robert De Niro kicked over. And it's all closed down, unfortunately. But I wanted to come here and see it. And it's a beautiful day out. We're near the airport, as you can hear the planes flying over. And now we're going to go from this point. We're going to go up to a diner called Airline Diner, which was in a movie as well. And I just want to see some of these places. We just came from a place called Best Pizza, run by Frank Pinella, a young man that does the pizza show. All right, here we are. We're at the Airline Diner, which is the scene in the movie Goodfellas, another scene from the movie Goodfellas, with Joe Pesci and Ray Liotta coming to the picture. Basically, they said they were in Flushing. No, where's that? What's Coney Island? By Coney Island. What's that area? Yeah, well, down that way, but actually it was up here in, where are we at?
Astoria.
Astoria, yeah, Astoria, Queens, right?
Astoria, by LaGuardia.
LaGuardia Airport, right, and the airport that was in the movie was actually LaGuardia. But any event, we came here, it's now called Jackson Hole, and but it still has the Airline Diner signs you can see up in the background there. And it's a beautiful day. Again, like I said, we're over here by the highway. Everything's great. And we're going to see you at the next location. Okay, we're at the scene of a movie that was made in 1947 starring Victor Mature. You know who he was. He was a great actor in the 50s and early 60s. And he made a movie right on this location. It was one of the scenes. It was called The Kiss of Death. It was made right here. Shows him coming across the street right here, and he went this direction as I'm going, basic direction. This building was not there at the time of the movie. There was just a green there, and he come down the street. He just come down from work, and if you watch the movie, you'll understand why what he was doing. And his kids, two little girls that were portrayed in the movie, came running up to him right in this spot here. And he greeted his kids, you know, and they came and they grabbed onto his belt. They were on roller skates, and he drug them up the street. Like he was just dragging them like this. And this house was there. This house was here, 47. And he dragged them all the way up here. I'm sure this is a new sidewalk since that time, but these houses were here. I recognize all of these fences and everything. And when he got to this location up in this corner, right here, he went into a house that was right here. The house is no longer here, just this apartment building. But you can see this wall in the background. Now he went down two steps that were right here, and this was about 3 feet lower than where I'm standing. And he went into the house right here. But this is the exact location where that movie was made, in 1947. Okay, here we are. We're at this park. What's the name of this park?
I don't know.
Park, New York Park. But over there, that is the Hell's Gate Bridge. And the Hell's Gate Bridge is made famous by Lionel. And it's a railroad bridge. And it's what attracted me to the place where we just came from, where the movie Kiss of Death was filmed, on 14th Street, which is right at the end of the street. And you can see the Hell's Gate Bridge in the background. The reason why we had to come over here was since 1947 till today, which is 71 years ago, none of these trees were here. So you could actually see the bridge in the back.
We're going over to a railroad barge. The next stop is going to be a railroad barge we're going to look at. And we'll see you over there. We're here at Red Hook, right? Okay. And behind me here is the Lehigh Valley Railroad Barge. And we're going to go in there. It's a museum and everything. And just to give you an example of where we're at, if the camera will follow this direction, if you turn around, you can see behind me there is the Statue of Liberty. So that's where we're at. We're below, actually below the tip of Manhattan. So we're going to go into the museum now.
A gang of 24 that would load this space with 300 tons of goods. Bags and barrels and bundles of rice and wheat and flour and sugar. The cabin was taken off the top when they took several of these wooden posts out. One would have been standing right here. They took those out in order to move goods around with hydraulic machines. That dropped the number of men that they needed from 24 down to less than a dozen. They took the cabin off the top because they could no longer support it without the wooden beam, and then they replaced the little cabin in the back is what replaced the cabin up top. They moved the families ashore, and what remains today is the captain's quarters of where he would be just by himself. And you're welcome to come and take a look at it back right here.
Okay, we're over here at
Sutton's Bar.
Sutton's Bar and Red Hook.
Sutton's Bar and Red Hook, okay. But, and this is John, and this is Maureen and Eileen. Maureen and Eileen, okay.
Yep.
Sisters.
Yeah, we're sisters.
Who? Yeah, all right.
Her and I are sisters.
Okay, and you're married to her?
No. Not yet.
Almost. Not yet, okay. Right. But anyway, we're down here in Red Hook. We just came from the barge across the street, which is a very interesting place, by the way. And we met these two great people down there, and they're very personable, and we thought we'd just talk to them. Now, we're down here from where?
From Florida.
Oh, okay. But you lived around here one time.
Yeah, I was born here.
Yeah.
I was born here, and we lived here until I was 9 years old.
All right.
Sonny's Bar has been here forever.
I thought that I've seen this somewhere before in this place, on TV or someplace.
Yes, I'm sure you have.
I thought I did. I watch a lot of YouTube. I'm on YouTube. But
I was too young for it to be my stomping ground, but it was my mother's stomping ground.
So this is like down by the harbor. Was there other buildings here one time, houses or anything?
It was always an industrial area. Mm-hmm. The Norwegian lived a lot down here, and they lived in the projects. You know, the New York housing at that time. And it was a beautiful place to grow up with. It started to change in the 60s and everybody kind of disappeared. Now it's building up again.
Great. We're here at Ucala, is that how it's pronounced? Ucali, right?
Ucali.
Ucali, okay. And this is a pizzeria owned by Mark Iacono. I saw him on the pizza show with Frank Pinella, and we decided to come over here to get some pizza. And there's a line probably quarter of a block long, I guess. And we're getting there. It hasn't opened yet, so we're getting ready to go in, and we'll see you on the inside. Thank you.
Do you remember your first slice of pizza? And when was it?
Yeah.
Oh, I absolutely do. And the side story is actually that pizza was my second word after mom.
Really?
Yeah. So I definitely cared a lot about pizza as a little boy. And I remember walking with my parents and like with like my hand and my like, you know, people were tall around me to go to the pizza place. And that I would look over the counter and watch him like turning tossing the dough. And I thought it was really cool.
Now Jeremy, you come from Chicago, right?
Yeah.
And they have what's their
deep,
pizza?
Deep dish, yeah.
Which is not pizza.
Not
right?
Pizza, it's a casserole.
So a Chicago person admits this.
Well, I've been in New York long enough. I've been in New York for 15 years, so I've learned my lesson that the best pizzas
are
here, not in Chicago. Yeah.
Okay, I've heard from Kate now that you think that New York pizza is not as good.
Right, but I didn't answer your first question.
You didn't answer my first question.
Yeah, which is that I believe my first pizza that I remember would probably be Di Lorenzo's.
Yeah.
Because I remember going there when I was very young and on the Hudson Street location. And I remember there being no bathroom. And being very young and going there with mom and dad.
I remember a story that you had to go to the bathroom.
Their apartment. So I think tomato pie, Di Lorenzo's tomato pie is probably my first pizza memory. What's your second question?
And my second question is, how does New York pizza compare to Trenton?
To Trenton pizza?
Yeah.
Average
New York pizza.
There's less, there's more plum tomatoes, chunky tomatoes.
Yeah.
New York pizza has a more sweet, like, you know, uniform sauce.
I agree.
Mm-hmm. Trenton tomato pie has got a more burnt, thin crust, whereas New York pizza has more of a dough. Trenton tomato pie, you can pick up a slice and it kind of breaks one point in the middle, but a New York slice flops.
Yeah, it flops, that's right.
Yeah,
it's transport-oriented pizza.
But it's not, it's very similar to New York pizza and Trenton tomato pie are similar, whereas Philly pizza and Trenton tomato pie are like...
Philly pizza doesn't even deserve a place on this list.
Philly pizza is really bad.
Yeah. Hey, okay, we tried to go to Locali, is that the name of the place? And it was like, wait, forget about it. I mean, we'd be eating breakfast there. It's so long, and that's great. However, we determined that it was a better place. So we came over here to Giuseppini, which is something to do with Giuseppe, but it's supposedly the same people. So we came over here, and we just got our pie. We've only been here 10 minutes. We got our pie. It's a wonderful place. It's very friendly. So we'll let you know how the pizza is. We'll take a picture.
Just beat the crowd. Love
you guys. Okay. Well, that concludes our trip to Brooklyn area, Queens, and Astoria. And we went to a really nice pizza place down the street here. and hope you enjoyed the video. Please subscribe, and we'll see you again on the next video, and thanks for watching.